A message from beyond the ether. In an astonishing announcement made this week, the Charles River Mad Scientists League revealed that their highly sensitive Teslaic wireless apparatus have picked up what appeared to be intelligent signals of extraterrestrial origin. The League's top astronomers and engineers have pinpointed the source of the signal to somewhere on the surface of the moon. Inspired by the possible existence of lunar life forms, the League has enlisted the aid of two of the most ingenious minds of their age, H.G. Wells and Jules Verne, to co-lead an expedition to the moon. However, the mission is already off to a rocky start.
You insufferable, single-minded nincompoop! Of course there is!
Imbecile! There can be no life on the moon! It has no hospitable atmosphere!
Neither does France. But you seem to be managing.
Bah! I wipe my nose at you and your silly English moustache.
Unable to surmount their difference of opinion, Wells and Verne will each be leading separate expeditions. Wells in an anti-gravity vessel like that from his novel, The First Men in the Moon, and Verne in a shuttle fired from a Columbiad space cannon, as in his novel, From the Earth to the Moon. In anticipation of the possible presence of intelligent lunar beings, Her Majesty Queen Mercy Rillette has appointed Captain Edward von Arkham and Mayor Solomon Sedgwick to accompany Wells and Verne, and to serve as ambassadors on behalf of Watch City.
Who better to entrust with lunar diplomacy than Watch City's two biggest lunatics?
Von Arkham shall be traveling with Wells aboard his ship, Sedgwick with Verne upon his. The two prospective ambassadors expressed enthusiasm for the upcoming voyage.
Going to the moon, going to the moon. Goody, goody, gadzooks, we're going to the moon. Yay!
Well, of course I'm excited. Do you know what the market is like for moon cheese? I'm going to be rich!
The voyage has been scheduled for Saturday, May 8th. Visit watchcityfestival.com for the complete schedule. Join us and boldly go!